Hello students of Standard 6, a very happy good morning to you all. Today we are going to learn Painting the Fence, Part 1. Painting a fence. Fence is a boundary around the field or house, but not with bricks and cement. It is a fence, either iron bar or some sticks or bamboo pieces. So with that it is made a fence. Tom Sawyer, we have seen, he was a naughty boy and Polly was looking for him and he was not available. So Aunt Polly waited for him in the night. When he came, jumped through window, she caught hold of him with his collar. And she saw that fully he was dirty and also fully torn his clothes. So she asked him, "What you were doing? Surely you might have fought in the village with some children," as he was very white. And then what she did, she told him, "Tomorrow is the Saturday, so you must do the white wash all around the fence. And it should be completed and done properly." He was so disappointed because weekend he used to go near the pump and play in the water, go to the river, play, laugh with the friends, enjoy. All laughter was gone because he had punishment. Now let us see what she is doing. After breakfast, Aunt Polly gave Tom a bucket of whitewash and a long handle brush. So a bucket she gave and she put a long handle brush where he can take and do the painting everywhere. "Now you get on with it," after breakfast told, "take this and go and start your work," she said, her face set and determined. As she said that much, her face was very strong, very determined that Tom should do his work. Tom had no choice. He sighed deeply as he looked up at the high board fence. He had no other choice. As he looked at the fence, he had really fear what to do, how to complete. He dipped the brush in the bucket of whitewash and passed it along the topmost plank. So he dipped the brush in the paint and he took for the whitewash and he was on the topmost. He started first and not even much done where something happens. Tom had not worked when a little boy came skipping out of the gate carrying a tin of paint. Tom greeted the boy, "Hello, Jim." "What?" But Jim ran along. "Can't stop, Master Tom," he said as he ran. "Mrs. told me I had to go and get some water from the pump." So little boy came inside out for the water. He wanted to go. Then Tom saw and he said, "Hello, Jim." But Jim, hearing his noise, he ran. And while running, he said, "Hi, Master. I can't stop. Aunt Polly has told me to get some water from the village pump." But Jim was dead scared. Tom suddenly saw a way out of his problem. The pump was in the village. If he could go down to the village to fetch water, he could escape the whitewashing. Here, Tom said, "Give me the bucket pail and I will fetch water for you." So he said, "Give me the bucket, I will get for you water. And you do this work." But Jim was very frightened of the ant. But Jim was dead scared. Scared means very frightened. She whacked me means slapped, very badly slapped. He said, rolling his eyes, she will cut off my head. She will slap also and she will cut my head also. So I don't do. Never, replied Tom. He said, no, she will not do. Look, I will give you my best marble. He said, wait, give me, I will go, I'll give you also marble also. Jim was almost tempted. He put down the pail and held out his hand for the treasure. Next minute, he was flying down the street, pail in hand, his bottom still singing, stealing from the dead bag that Aunt Polly had given him. As for Tom, he was so scared at the very sight of his aunt that he returned to the white was as if he depended on it. So, first Jim was tempted to take and he kept the bucket and he spread his hand. Suddenly he remembered Aunt Polly had given him back on his back and that is still paining, still that pain is there. Took the bucket and ran and he said, no, I can't do it. Tom was also frightened of Aunt Polly, he will get punishment. So he went back, took the white wash and brush, he started to paint. But a little later, Aunt Polly went back to the house again and Tom put down his brush. He searched in his pocket that and brought out all his worldly wealth. So he's telling that he, as Aunt Polly went inside, he kept the brush in the bucket and sat near the tree and looked in his pocket. He found only few broken toy pieces and two marble and one bended pail. And he said, oh, nothing is there to give the boys and make them to work. I don't have anything. What shall I do? See, stealing. It was not much. Some broken bits of toys, two marbles and bent pin. There was nothing that he could trade with the other boys for a spell of freedom and from whitewash. So he thought if other boys are there, they can do some painting and I can give them something. But there wasn't anything for him to escape. So he could not get help. If somebody get help, you have to give something like that. They also will be happy and they like to do it. So he did not have any. Here he is mentioned worldly treasure. Worldly treasure means the little things, what is available for him in the sea, what we use, that is all worldly property. So he is telling worldly treasure. So children, see, when you don't know to do the work, when you are lazy, you will never learn to do. Tom was always escaping and playing torrent. And because of that, he did not know to do the work. Whitewash is very easy, only you need to work out. And then he was so much afraid what to do. And Polly will punish if the work is not done. So children, you all should learn to do the work in the house and what is necessary for you. And daily do your work. Little by little, if you do daily, you will not have more. And if you are keeping not today, tomorrow, then today's work and tomorrow's work, double it becomes. And then again pending, again it becomes more and more. And at the end, you cannot complete. So daily work, you must complete daily. Okay, children. Thank you.